Heavenly Father, we thank you for today and for another opportunity to serve. We ask your blessings with us, our worship team, members of our parish family, and all those who share this opportunity with us. May the Holy Spirit guide us in all that we do, and what is done to your honor and glory. We especially remember today as we celebrate the life of St. Columba, the determination and dedication given to build God's kingdom. May that thought, may that desire be in us as we go forward from this place. So we ask you to continue to be our guide now and forevermore. Amen.
Today, June 9th, we reflect on the life of the Venerable Columba, Abbot of Iona 597. Columba, an abbot and a missionary, was born in Ireland in 521. Patrick of Ireland had prophesied about his birth, saying, "He will be a saint and will be devout. He will be an abbot, the king of royal graces." St. Columba, also known as Columcille, meaning Dove of the Church, became a monk at an early age and was soon ordained a priest. According to tradition, around 560, he became involved in a dispute over the right to copy an edition of the Psalter. The dispute eventually led to a battle in 561, during which many men were killed. As a penance for these debts, Columba was ordered to make the same number of new converts he had killed in the battle. Of course, he was also ordered to leave Ireland. He traveled to Scotland and eventually landed on the island of Iona, where he founded a monastery. For 30 years, he evangelized, studied, wrote, and governed his monastery. He supervised his monks in their works in the field, in their worship, in their study and teaching. There are many stories of miracles which he performed during his mission to convert the Picts, the people who dwelt in Scotland in those days. As fate would have it, he died peacefully while working on a copy of the Psalter. He had put down his pen, rested a few hours, and at matins, he was found dead before the altar, a smile on his face. His biographer, Adam Nann, quoted him as having said, "This day is called in the sacred scripture a day of rest, and truly to me it will be such, for it is the last of my life, and I shall enter into rest after the fatigues of my labor." St. Columba is believed to be buried together with St. Patrick and St. Bridget of Kildare, deep in the famous hill of Down. Today, we remember this saint, the Venerable Columba, Abbot of Iona. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Our service continues on page 34. Christ came and preached peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him, we both have access in one spirit to the Father. Hear us, O Lord,
for
your mercy is great. We will exalt you, O God, our Savior,
and praise your name forever and ever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now and shall be forever.
Amen. We say together, Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and a thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and the saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen.
Come rejoice before your Maker, all you peoples of the earth. Serve the Lord your God with gladness. Come before him with a song. Know for certain that Jehovah is the true and only God. Will his will has made us. We are sheep within his fold. Come with grateful hearts before him. Enter now his courts with praise. Show your thankfulness towards him. Give due honor to his name. For the Lord our God is gracious, everlasting in his love. And to every generation his great faithfulness endures.
Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. In a moment of silence, let us bring our sins, known and unknown, before God. We pray together. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
God of grace and God of glory, on thy people pour thy power. Crown thine ancient church a story, bring her bud to glorious flower. Grant us wisdom, grant us courage, for the facing of this hour. Lo, the hosts of evil round us scorn thy Christ, assail his ways. From the fears that long have bound us, free our hearts to faith and praise. Grant us wisdom, grant us courage, for the living of these days. Cure thy children's warring madness, bend our pride to thy control. Shame our wanton selfish gladness, rich in things and poor in soul. Grant us wisdom, grant us courage, lest we miss thy kingdom's goal. Save us from weak resignation to the evils we deplore. Let the search for thy salvation be our glory evermore. Grant us wisdom, grant us courage, serving thee whom we adore.
Psalm 61. Hear my cry, O God, and listen to my prayer. I call upon you from the ends of the earth with heaviness in my heart. Set me upon the rock that is higher than I. For you have been my refuge, a strong tower against the enemy. I will dwell in your house forever. I will take refuge under the cover of your wings. For you, O God, have heard my vows. You have granted me the heritage of those who fear your name. Add length of days to the king's life. Let his years extend over many generations. Let him sit enthroned before God forever. Bid love and faithfulness watch over him. So will I always sing the praise of your name. and day by day I will fulfill my vows.
Psalm 62. For God alone, my soul in silence weeps. From Him comes my salvation. He alone is my rock and my salvation, my stronghold, so that I shall not be greatly shaken. How long will you assail me to crush me, all of you together? As if you were leaning a fence or toppling a wall. They seek only to bring me down from my place of honor. Lies are their chief delight. They bless with their lips, but in their hearts they curse. For God alone, my soul in silence weeps. Truly, my hope is in Him. He alone is my rock and my salvation, my stronghold, so that I shall not be shaken. In God is my safety and my honor. God is my strong rock and my refuge. Put your trust in Him always, O people. Pour out your heart before Him, for God is our refuge. Those of high degree are but a fleeting breath. Even those of low estate cannot be trusted. On the scales, they are lighter than breath. All of them together. Put no trust in extortion. In robbery, take no pride. Though wealth increase, set not your heart upon it. God has spoken once. Twice I have heard it. That power belongs to God. Steadfast love is yours, O Lord, for you repay everyone according to his deeds. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Mm.
The reading is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verses 14 to 9, and chapter 10. There is a vanity that takes place on earth, that there are righteous people who are treated according to the conduct of the wicked, and there are wicked people who are treated according to the conduct of the righteous. I said that this also is vanity. So I commend enjoyment, for there is nothing better for people under the sun than to eat and drink and enjoy themselves, for this will go with them in their toil through the days of life that God gives them under the sun. When I applied my mind to know wisdom and to see the business that is done on earth, how one's eyes see sleep neither day nor night, then I saw all the work of God, that no one can find out what is happening under the sun. However much they may toil in seeking, they will not find it out. Even though those who are wise claim to know, they cannot find out. All this I laid to heart, examining it all, how the righteous and the wise and their deeds are in the land of God. Whether it is love or hate, one does not know. Everything that confronts them is vanity, since the same fate comes to all, to the righteous and the wicked, to the good and the evil, to the clean and the unclean, to those who sacrifice and to those who do not sacrifice. As the good, so are the sinners. Those who swear are like those who shun an oath. There is an evil in all that happens under the sun, that the same fate comes to everyone. Moreover, the hearts of all are full of evil. Madness is in their hearts while they live, and after that they go to the dead. But whoever is joined with all the living has hope, for a living dog is better than a dead lion. The living know that they will die, but the dead know nothing. They have no more reward, and even the memory of them is lost. Their love and their hate and their envy have already perished. Never again will they have any share in all that happens under the sun. Go, eat your bread with enjoyment, and drink your wine with a merry heart, for God has long ago approved what you do. Let your garments always be white. Do not let oil be lacking on your head. Enjoy life with the wife whom you love, all the days of your vain life that are given you under the sun, because that is your portion in life and in your toil at which you toil under the sun. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with your might, for there is no work or thought or knowledge or wisdom in Sheol to which you are going. Here ends the reading.
Glory to you, O Father God, to you all praise is known. Your holy name shines forth in light. We praise and honor you. In temples of splendor, kingdom come, to you all praise is known. We praise and honor you. In heaven's high and depths beneath, to you all praise is due. Father and Son and the Spirit, Lord, we praise and honor you.
Chapter 15, beginning at verse 29. After Jesus had left that place, he passed along the Sea of Galilee, and he went up the mountain where he sat down. Great crowds came to him, bringing with them the lame, the maimed, the blind, the mute, and many others. They put them at his feet, and he cured them, so that the crowd was amazed when they saw the mute speaking, the maimed whole, the lame walking, and the blind seeing, and they praised the God of Israel. Then Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I have compassion for the crowd, because they have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat. And I do not want to send them away hungry, for they might faint on the way. The disciples said to him, where are we to get enough bread in the desert to feed so great a crowd? Jesus asked them, how many loaves have you? They said, 7, and a few small fish. Then ordering the crowd to sit down on the ground, he took the 7 loaves and the fish. And after giving thanks, he broke them and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And all of them ate and were filled. And they took up the broken pieces left over, 7 baskets full. Those who had eaten were 4,000 men, besides women and children. After sending away the crowds, he got into the boat and went to the region of Magadan. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Master,
that cheereth. Master, let it now be heard. I am listening, Lord, for thee. What hast thou to say to me? Speak to me by name, O Master. Let me know.
Share with me an affirmation. The Almighty God is our Father. He sent His Son Jesus to teach us His ways. God's word is true. We believe in this. Believe in His Son, and life in the Spirit sets us free. So we are free indeed, and we claim His promises. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A pleasure to be able to share some thoughts with you this morning, brothers and sisters. Our passage for today's Gospel, taken from Matthew 15:29-39, is perhaps just part of the entire chapter of Matthew 15. And what I would like to recommend, if you have time later on today, study that passage. It carries a message for us, a message that allows us to truly understand what God wants from us and how He is able, even when we feel we are in a position where He cannot understand us, He knows our hearts. And so I will quickly touch on the aspects of the passage before coming to that final part of the reading. And I will want to look at the particular words, "What do you have?" taken from the passage, a gospel passage, Jesus speaking to His disciples, asking them, at that critical moment, what do you have? Matthew 15 is one of those passages where the Pharisees and Sadducees have come out to Jesus. They are the church. They are the elders. They are the ones who know what should be done. And based on what they have seen, His disciples are treading on the tradition of the elders. And so they came to Him with that question. As is His teaching style, He also challenged them. He says to them, "You do not necessarily obey the law, because you say to yourselves and to your mothers and fathers, whom God has given that special blessing which you should uphold, that it is for them to note that when you get to this age, you do not have to give them any support. Whatever support you give is to God. So he reminds them that this is one of your commandments. And so you are teaching human precepts and not the precepts of God. The disciples came letting him know how upset the Sadducees and Pharisees were. And he said to them, that generation, we expect that of them. We expect that of them. And he went on to speak of Isaiah outlining it. So they were not clear on what was happening when they asked him to explain. And he certainly did. He drew the reference to them and told them, what goes in the body does not defile, but what comes out. And he drew to their attention the fact that the things that are hurtful, the things that are offensive to God, the things that make God not accept our presence and our desire and our worship are the things that set us apart from him, like murder, suicide, like theft, like slander, like sexual immorality, and all these other false witnesses, and all these other faulty expressions, which as human beings, we share one with another. Those are the things that separate us from God's love. Not the washing, because that doesn't come from our heart. And so here, he's pointing them to the knowledge that we need to be careful and note how we treat with each other and what we say. He has therefore drawn to their attention that one of the critical things in life is, what is your motive for what are you doing? What is your motive? So the motives of the Pharisees and Sadducees were not clear. They came to challenge him. He continues, or the passage, the chapter continues with a woman, Syrophoenician woman, because he was near that area, a Gentile, coming to him, speaking and saying to him, her daughter is offended by demons, and she has had these attacks for most of her life. She heard of him and believes that he can heal, so she came. She had been there for some time and continuing to try to reach out to him without any help, to the point where it annoyed his disciples. And they came to him saying, listen, this woman is annoying, get rid of her. And he tells them, listen, I came to the lost sheep of Israel. That's who I came for. And so the woman heard this and she came to him earnestly pleading. And his words to her were, I cannot take the children's food and give it to the dogs. Now with such an insult, one would turn away and leave. That was not her desire. Her motive was to have Jesus, whom she believed was the only person who could support her, to give her more attention. And so her reply, even the dogs eat from their master's table. Noting the significance of what she said, he told her, your faith has made you well. Go, your daughter has been healed. And so, with that miracle, he continued along the seacoast, went up the mountains, and because the crowds had seen all that he had done, and the replies that he had given, they followed. And there was this great multitude following with him, and he continued to teach while they continued to bring all those who were ill, the lame, the maimed, the blind, and all of them, they brought them to him to be healed. So, without hesitating, he stretched out his hand in power and healed them. And they were amazed, and they glorified, as the passage tells us, the God of Israel. Despite being Gentiles, they glorified the God of Israel, because they are aware that here is someone who knows that God and is working through the power of that God for the benefit of God's people. It is here, at that place, where they would have been so satisfied with all that had gone, that they continued to remain there for 3 days. At the end of the third day, scriptures tell us Jesus had compassion on them because they were there for 3 days and had nothing to eat. He was not about to send them on their way. He was about to determine what can be done for them. So he approached his disciples, send them away that they can get food. But they knew how far it was from the nearest town. To him, it is too far. And he suggested that they must find something for them. So his question, their question to him, where can we find money to buy food for this multitude? So many of them. And we don't want to send them away. So, what do you have? What do you have? That question which Jesus is asking all of us today. What do you have that I could work with to make you what you want to be, or to assist you in getting to where you want to be? They had 7 loaves, and some small fish. So he took it. As was his custom, he looked up to the Father, who would have been his strength and support, asked his blessings, and then distributed it. The reading tells us, all were filled and satisfied, and of the crumbs they took up 7 baskets filled. I want us, my dear brothers and sisters, in closing this short message, to highlight the following points. Your motive in whatever you're doing is important. Does it come from a genuine desire, or does it come from a false pretense? If it comes from a false pretense, God sees to it, and it will not be satisfied. So note the Pharisees and Sadducees in the beginning of the chapter. If it comes from a faithful and determined option, God will know and will satisfy. So note the determination of the Syrophoenician woman. She could not and would not be turned away. In the end, note the love of God and his compassion, which reaches out to those who reach out to him. What do you have? 7 loaves and 2 small fishes. So he took it, blessed it, and fed them. This morning, I want to leave with you, my dear brothers and sisters, the notion that nothing that you have is too small to offer to God, because he is able, once your motive is purposeful, once your motive is the desire for the building of the body of Christ, once your motive as a disciple of Christ is to extend the kingdom, he can use it as he used those bread and fish to feed the 4,000. Note, you might even feed more than 4,000. So may God bless us to give back to him out of whatever little we have, so he could extend it to the glory of his kingdom. Amen?
Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead, and the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Suffrages Form A. Lord, reveal your love among us,
that we may know the joy of your
salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations,
and teach our leaders wisdom.
Endow your church with faithfulness,
and your servants with knowledge and true godliness.
Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed,
that your justice may be known among all people.
Lord, renew your spirit within us,
that in us and through us your will may be done.
The collect for the day is found on page 174, proper 5. O God, from whom all good proceeds, grant that by your inspiration we may think those things that are right, and by your merciful guiding may do them. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. In the worldwide Anglican Communion, we pray for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury. In the province of the West Indies, we pray for the Most Reverend Howard Gregory, Primate and Bishop of Jamaica. In our own diocese, we pray for Claude, our Bishop, and for retired Bishops Clive, Roll, and Calvin. In our parish, we pray for our clergy and laity, our youth, our sick and the shut-in, for those who celebrate birthdays and anniversaries at this time. We also pray for persons who have suffered from any of the ill effects of COVID-19. And we ask God's blessings upon our government as they continue with their astute leadership. And we look forward for the full reopening of our economy, and most importantly, the reopening of our churches. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for strength at this time, as we share our collect. May the strength of God pilot us. May the power of God preserve us. May the wisdom of God instruct us. May the hand of God protect us. May the way of God direct us. May the shield of God defend us. May the host of God guard us against the snares of evil and the temptations of the world. May Christ be with us, Christ before us, Christ in us, Christ over us. May your salvation, O Lord, be always ours, this day and forevermore. Amen. we continue with our intercessory prayers.
A prayer for peace. Eternal God, in his perfect kingdom, no sword is drawn but the sword of righteousness. No strength known but the strength of love. So mightily spread abroad your spirit, that all peoples may be gathered under the banner of the Prince of Peace, as children of one Father, to whom be dominion and glory, now and forever. Amen. Prayer for the parish. Almighty and ever-living God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, hear our prayers for this parish family. Strengthen the faithful, arouse the careless, and restore the penitent. Grant us all things necessary for our common life, and bring us all to be of one heart and mind within your holy church, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. A prayer for the unemployed. Heavenly Father, remember before you those who suffer want and anxiety from lack of work. Guide the people of this land so to use our public and private wealth that all may find suitable and fulfilling employment and receive just payment for their labor. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Prayer for those who influence public opinion. Almighty God, you proclaim your truth in every age by many voices. Direct in our time, we pray, those who speak where many listen and write what many read, that they may do their part in making the hearts of this people wise, its mind sound, and its will righteous, to the honor of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
On page 47, we say together the prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit. And in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
A pleasant good morning to everyone. It's good to have you here in the parish of St. Andrew during this online service. We want to say a special welcome to those persons who are visiting us for the very first time, as well as those persons who contributed towards the service this morning. All right, and I have been kind of cruising the visitors here today, and I really want to say thank you to the team or the person from St. Barnabas who is here with us today, St. Barnabas in Pleasantville. So I want to say thank you very much to the person who is here, as well as other persons who I may not have seen during this period of time. We, as I said earlier, during the beginning of this, before the service, I have mentioned that the more services you do, the less it is in terms of, or the closer it is to us being back in our churches. So we do look forward for our churches, and I would only believe that something that we have done during this service will remain with us when we return to those physical buildings. All right. I want to say a happy birthday to those persons celebrating birthdays this week, as well as a happy anniversary to those persons celebrating any special occasion during this period of time. All right, we continue to focus on our support in terms of what can you do to help one another. Remember to reach out to those persons. Yes, we are blessed enough in Trinidad and Tobago not to have any more COVID-19 cases at this point in time. But at the same time, we still have to be safe, everyone. Make sure and be safe. But at the same time, be safe, but don't forget other persons. Try and touch out to your parish family, because a little can go a long way. We continue our drive to distribute hampers to individuals and families. So continue to make those contributions to the parish office, as well as you can contact our clergy, and the information is on the screen so that you can contact anyone at moment's notice. Keep in mind that the parish office has reopened, and our temporary office hours are from Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. Of course, closed on public holidays. So people don't come on Corpus Christi, okay? All right? But should you need to contact the office, rest assured, don't be afraid to contact us at 679-2157. Or please pay attention to the WhatsApp number. You can contact via WhatsApp as well at 492-5835. The WhatsApp number should be up and running as early as tomorrow. All right? But persons can contact the parish office during any one of these formats whenever you are ready. For those persons who are able to make their contributions via the online deposits, I have also placed on the screen the information with regards to the account numbers. Rest assured, make a note of it. Pay attention to it, some of you. And I want to say thank you to those persons who have been making those contributions up to this time. But others, you can make a contribution. So the nice thing is you don't have to leave your home to make your contributions. You can make it right online. And rest assured, we will get it. And we are thankful for it in this parish as we move and we continue in terms of prepping or preparing the churches for reopening, which will be very, very soon. A gentle reminder again about the Bible studies Zoom sessions, which will be at 8 p.m. in Trinidad. So be sure to visit those. And if you see on the screen, a reminder that they start as early as, they started already actually, on the 7th of June. The next will be on the 14th of June with Mrs. Nicole Lynch from the Diocese of Barbados, followed by Father Darren Carlos from Aruba. And in July, we do have Father Aaron Charles and Father Kerry Marcel from the Turks and Caicos. Father Aaron Charles, of course, from the Diocese of Trinidad and Tobago. So look out for those Bible study sessions. All the information is there. Rest assured, join in, and I'm sure you will be happy and pleased about what you see. Be sure to visit our Facebook pages at Andrew Parish, as well as our YouTube page of the St. Andrew Parish Couva for all information with regards to the services that you have been seeing over the last few weeks. And I really want to say thank you to those persons who have been working with us during this period of time. Thank you very much to the clergy for the continual support and all those other persons who are on the service committee who have been ensuring that our services have been going as planned. I am seeing one or two. Oh yes, thank you, and thank you. I'm seeing the coming from St. Barnabas Parish. Thank you very much. We are happy to have you here in the parish of St. Andrew. So everyone, please take care and have a great day.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
A peaceful day. See you on Thursday.
Everybody for support. Thank you.
He knows my name. Yes, he knows my name.